Hi guys, welcome to Sai Darshan channel. So today we have an interesting video. It's all about deliveries, which is normal delivery and then C-section. So today what is trending? The trending delivery is C-section, because the majority of the people undergo C-sections nowadays. I tend to meet a lot of my friends. They tell me like they had a complicated, they have some complicity in their delivery, because of that they had a C-section. So let's first know about what is normal delivery and what is C-section. So normal delivery happens through your vagina, and when the pain comes, induces, you will have a lot of pain in between. So the contractions will happen to women, so that contractions will get burst out and the child will be born out. So that is called a normal delivery. And then C-section is some complicity if the child is not turning up, turning to the vaginal, and sometimes the umbilical cord get caught in the child, and because of that the child is not able to move it. And if the child has drinking a lot of water, which is the amniofluid water, so lot of complicities are there for a C-section. So during this emergency cases only C-section happens. Even some of the people who see the good day time, and then they will go and have this C-section because they don't want to undergo a big pain. See, the pain is there in both the deliveries, even in normal delivery and as well as in C-sections. So the pain is very common, and the pain will be for some time till the baby is born. For C-section also, nowadays a lot of new technologies have come, so the pain will be maximum will be there for 3 to 5 days. And previously they used to have stitches, and the stitches will be get removed after some days. And nowadays they have this melting threads which automatically absorbed by the skin. And lot of new things have come in C-section. C-section is happening because of some complicity which is the woman undergo to save both the mother and the child. The C-section is happening. So when you are pregnant, be sure and be aware for both the deliveries, and never ever go and search in YouTube or in some of the sites how the delivery happens. And it happens automatically. Just get prepared. If it is normal also, I'm going to accept. If it is C-section also, I'm going to accept. So normal delivery, you will have this pain. After that, the vaginal stitches will be there after your delivery, and you can eat all the food after delivery, and these are things very common. And for the C-section, after C-section definitely you will have pain, because there is two types of cut in the C-section. That one is a horizontal cut, one is vertical cut. So it's based on the baby position, the cut will be happening in below your belly button. And once the cut is made, and through that the baby is taken out. So the pain will be there, and you will be given injections. So before delivery you will have injection on your backbone. That backbone, it's because that pain you should not feel it, for that they will give that anesthesia and injection on your backbone. And then later, once after delivery also, you will be given injections to heal the body, and maximum 3 to 5 days the pain will completely will go. And after 10th day you can have your bath. After 3rd day itself they will ask you to have a shower, and after 10th day you can have a proper shower. Definitely the stomach has undergone a lot of stress all this 10 months, and it has had a lot of weight, and it is the muscles have stretched so much. So definitely it will be very soft and delicate, and it will take some time to get subside. So till then you have to give time for healing. That is very, very important. And when you are pregnant, try to do some exercises, which is very, very important for a normal delivery and as well as for your health. And exercises without anybody's knowledge, don't do any rough exercises. The exercises need to be good for the baby and as well as for yourself. And when you're pregnant, try to apply this stretch-free ointments which is available in the market, and you can ask your gynecologist as well. And you can, if you apply that, you will have reduced amount of stretch marks. And then you can apply even coconut oil, which definitely will help a lot in stretch mark removal. And when you start applying on your pregnancy, then only it can be you know, that stretch marks will be removed. When you are applying post your delivery, that is not going to help you out. And another thing, like definitely don't think that food is for two. So a lot of people say like you should eat for two, for yourself and for your kid. That is not the scenario, because the food is not going to for two. Just we need some extra calories for the child, and whatever food you take from that, the baby will get, food will be get absorbed. And when you're eating, please eat nutrition food. We'll have lot of carvings. Definitely you can take all your carvings, whatever you like to eat, but take it in a lesser quantity, the junk foods. And take lot of fruits, vegetables, tender coconut, and especially which is good for your calcium deficiency and good for your iron, because iron is so much important. If your blood report says less iron, or if blood RBC and WBC, definitely the doctor will advise you to eat more. Sometimes even injections are given for that, and tablets are given. So don't take it to that level. So try to eat something. Some people will be having vomiting sensation, morning sickness. There are a lot of things, nausea. So whatever it is, try to split your food in equal quantities. Like every 1 hour, you can eat little quantity. That will definitely help yourself. You'll have a lot of energy, and your child will also get nutrition out of your food. And if you have vomiting sensation, there are a lot of tablets which will reduce the vomiting sensation, but don't take it in a longer run. And first understand your body and what exactly it needs, because the hormone secretion will be heavy during that time. And always keep a mindset, if it is a normal delivery or a C-section, you will get prepared for it. If you are preparing for that, your mind, then definitely you will not get shocked when you have to undergo a C-section. And please keep in mind, don't increase your baby's weight. A lot of women does that. Once they eat more and they don't exercise, they don't go for a walk, definitely the baby's weight will increase. Because of that, you need to have a C-section. In my case, that is what happened, because I never had a vomiting sensation, so I tempted to eat lot of food. So that made my baby to have lot of weight. So that is one thing. And take adequate glasses of water, which is very, very important, because your fluid level needs to be right on your body. So keep it that in the mind. And post your delivery, what happens? Post your delivery, if it is a C-section, definitely you are going to have a back pain. And after some time, definitely you need to do exercises, and you need to take deficiency, you know, the calcium iron tablets, because you will have lot of hair fall. And that is very, very common, because after post your delivery, your all your energy will go, and you have to retain back your energy by taking your proper food. And always remember to feed your child, because the pregnancy weight, whatever you have put on, needs to get reduced, because that weight is a stubborn weight. If you don't reduce your weight, definitely that weight is going to stay on your body. And the breastfeeding helps you to reduce your weight on a longer run. So always breastfeed your child, and the more you feed, the more weight you reduce. And try to do small exercises for your, if it is a C-section, wear a belt after 45 days. You can ask your gynecologist, and you can wear a belt for your stomach, which is very important. In jockey, in lot of sites, they sell this belts. Whatever comfortable for you, you can buy that. You can ask your gynecologist as well. And if it is a normal delivery also, please wear the belt. After 10 days or 15 days, you can wear, I think. You have to wear your belt, because the stomach needs to come back to the shape. The delivery time, it has expended, the skin is expended a lot. Pamper your skin as much as possible. That would be my advice, because the skin has undergone a lot of stress or this 10 months. Like, you can have some nice oil massage, not immediately after 6 months. You can have nice oil massage, you can have nice spa, or if you have a head massage. So all these things will make your skin rejuvenate fast, and you will be out of the stress very faster. And love your child. Definitely you are going to have sleepless nights, and definitely you are going to take care of your newborn child, which is going to be a challenge, because new mom, definitely it's going to be a challenge. But this period shall pass away. Definitely after some times, these memories will make you smile. So happy parenting. So I hope I've cleared some of your doubts on this C-section and normal delivery. And if you have any doubts, please comment on my comment box, so that I'll be happy to assist with you based on my experience. And please share your experience as well, so that we will have a similar, we can laugh with our experiences. Thank you so much for watching Sai Darshan channel. I hope you like my channel. Please subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you so much, friends.